This is StoryRobot. Welcome to r/ProRevenge. Our first story of today is, I catfished a former boss to get paid. I used to work for a married couple. Billy, male 52, and Gigi, female 44, who owned a business services public relations agency. It lasted more or less for a year. They seemed nice and humble, but in reality, they were shady and untruthful. The company began to falter because of poor management and zero intention to prioritize. Billy was your baby-faced next-door neighbor type. He looked about 10 years younger and had a kind smile. He was soft-spoken and had an artistic and creative flair to him. Gigi looked matronly with a Mother Earth incarnate attitude towards her children. She prided herself on being ruthless when it came to giving her family only the best. She could be really nice when she wanted to, but I found out early on that she was 100% apt at gossip and being two-faced. The company's constant changes were a red flag. They went from business services plus PR agency to IT provider, to a business incubator, to indie beer partners. What I'm trying to say is that they tried to dip their donut on everyone's coffee, figuratively. Some of us had no real way to escape. The lady working next to me was already 67 years old and scared that no one would hire her. I wasn't in a great place either. We were 8 employees in total. They wouldn't lay anyone off because they believed that the employee should quit. They paid us only a portion of our salaries, incomplete weekly payments. Employees would run for the hills once they found a better job. Some of us were stuck. It was horrible. Then, they would pay the normal rate for a month and then do it again. They never cut down on their luxury expenses, so the wife would post her shopping sprees or arrive in a new car like it was nothing. Zero empathy. Very insensitive. The husband was obsessed with making it big time. So much, that he sometimes failed to see an opportunity right in front of him. He said he was Coca-Cola's brand manager. I swear I looked it up and could never find any reference. Gigi had a display full of small local magazines, mostly about design and architecture. They were very proud to be a team member, but in reality, they just helped them print 2 issues. They wanted big business only, but in the meantime, looked down upon tangible potential clients. Like the young Latino couple who showed up trying to learn more about their services. They seemed lost because they wanted someone to help them set up a coffee business and had no idea how it was done. I talked to them and helped them into the waiting room. They even showed up with their baby in a stroller. That means they must have driven by and decided to come in. An impulsive client should be retained. The guy said his grandpa had a farm and he wanted to create an import-exports company. Once Billy showed up, he listened for a bit, then kind of gave them a kind of an abrupt dismissal. That was a beep move because that couple opened their own business with someone else and even have a Facebook page. It could have been Billy. Billy lined his office walls with posters of Steve Jobs and Elon Musk. His wife, the chief enabling officer, put up signs on each room. The main employee area was the machine room, Billy's office was the chamber, the conference room was a meeting of the minds. Every time an employee disagreed with Billy during a brainstorming session, Gigi would call them aside and tell them that Billy is your boss. You need to know that he is brilliant and a genius. I want him to have that taste of success. I experienced that firsthand. I also hated brainstorming because that was never on my job description. They just wanted to pick everyone's brains. In the meantime, we had to see the Pandora jewelry, the expensive makeovers for their daughters, and the weekend at the spa updates on Facebook. Gigi's captions were usually about rewarding herself after a hard week or because she deserved it. Oh, and I'd like to mention that they bought into the social guru phrases about emotional direction. So if an employee ever got angry, Gigi would tell you, remember, the one who gets angry is the one who ends up losing. For anyone who's been in this situation, you may understand how painful it can be. You cannot leave the job because you have no other job waiting for you, and pathetic as it may sound to some income is better than no income at all. This is an involuntary compromise and it's abusive. Why were we expected to pay for their luxuries via incomplete wages? My best friend's ex is into coding and programming and he agreed to help. If it didn't work out, at least we would have something to laugh about. We created a Kickbeep fake website with a matching LinkedIn and the whole 9 yards. To make a long story short, this was supposed to be an investment company and my friend would be very casual. Nothing too eager. He started by liking my employer's Facebook page, then comment. Before we knew, my boss took the bait and was engaging. They exchanged emails and he was eager to share all his projects and ambitious beep. On the other side, the investor sent him a list of requirements, like proof of concept, employer payroll, ein hash, etc. The investor agreed to work them if they could prove they were legit and up to date. No bank account of confidential info was asked. Within 3 weeks, I was paid the equivalent to the 2.5 months I was owed. The investor did an about face and never contacted him again. I left the job as soon as I could. My friend who remained until she got paid told me our boss seemed off and a bit down after he announced big things are coming, but it all seemed to deflate. I never disclosed what was really going on. Our final story of today is: be a racist and lie on your neighbors? Welcome to Eviction, Population U. Anyone who has seen my posts know I used to work in the private security field. Not mall cops, but highly trained and skilled in armed security. We worked residential buildings and complexes that were very high-end, like $200,000 cars in the parking garages high-end. Now places like this are Karen Central. Imagine apartments full of Karens and entitled teenagers. Now the company owner was awesome. A cop as his regular job, he understood what we faced. His advice was to be nice but put the hammer down if you have to and don't take their beep. Also that if we didn't get 2 complaints a month about us for worthless beep that weren't engaging the residents enough, lol. So, this is important to the revenge. Each supervisor had 10 to 15 properties under their control. Regular officers patrolled them, but we were in charge of helping with evictions, attending town halls on security issues, deciding how an officer patrols or updating what areas are being a problem or needing checked. I had 12. Now in this one apartment complex we had a couple always calling us. We has an emergency line open from 6 p.m. to 6 a.m. When we get there they cry about their upstairs neighbor. It was a list of things they just changed. Stomping, music, talking, cooking smells, their dog going number one on the balcony and it dripping onto theirs. Valid complaints, if we found evidence and we never did. When they see we were starting to question if they were real they changed tactics and went racist. The couple above them were a sweet and wonderful middle-aged Asian couple. Husband was an immigrant, but the wife was a born and raised American. These racist creates had only talked to the husband so they assumed, as all racists do, that they were both immigrants. So, this white sheet-wearing couple started making comments like those Asians and they are in America. Why can't they cook American food, and I'm afraid to be in the parking garage when one of them is driving in it, while it angered me those comments alone weren't enough for an eviction. Only thing I could do was have my officers put exact phrasing in the report. I did ask the property manager about the comments and she said if they didn't say them to the residents and the residents didn't complain there wasn't much she could do. So I tried to think of some way to get them evicted. Not only were they lying to get a couple evicted, but were calling in false things and wasting the officers' time to respond. And they didn't call just every once in a while. They called sometimes twice in a night, usually 5 to 8 times a week. So, a month later the opportunity was handed to me. The Asian couple called me during the day and informed me they were going out of the country, China, for 2 weeks and no one would be in their apartment. They told me this just in case the other couple start complaining I would know they were lying, and asked to check their door once a night to make sure it was locked and not broken into. I informed the Asian couple to not tell their neighbor, none of them that they were leaving and besides myself only tell the property manager. We had a patrol meeting that night. Officers didn't work one specific region. So I told them all my plan. I wanted them to respond each time they call and write down exactly what they said happened and also any racial terms no matter how minor. Mark the report urgent and send it out. We had an online system for all business. Email, schedules, report submitting, you get the idea. So away we go. During those 14 days they complained 18 times. Everything was documented and I took it to the manager. She looked it over and said let's evict them. Side note. The client gets charged more for emergency response than they do for regular patrols. Meaning their lies were costing money. So, there was no HOA because they were rentals. In this situation myself, the property manager and the tenant sit down at a table. The charges for eviction or read. If the eviction of security related then I say what violations have been broken etc., not opinions, just facts based on the reports which the tenants get a copy of. Then the tenants have a right to speak and ask questions. The property manager then decides what happens next. Do they stay or do they go? So they were sent a formal letter stating they were facing eviction and had 10 days to set up a meeting. If not the eviction will be processed. They sit one up. I get there and the beephole couple and the manager are already present. The wife immediately digs into me because I was armed. Uniforms for those situations are a dress shirt, slacks, tie and one weapon and one magazine. Things like elections can be dangerous. I just politely informed her that it was my uniform and not her call to make. She tried to say she felt uncomfortable and wanted to reschedule but the manager said this happens now or I will evict you. So they agreed to continue. Now for legal reasons these sessions were recorded by video, that way the tenant can't lie in eviction court or sue. In front of me were all 18 reports and went over each one. Time, date, who called apartment number. I also read out each line telling them to tell me what they feel is false and what is true. The only thing they said the racial terms weren't true. At the end of each report I basically said the report is accurate in the fact that tenants in apartment XYZ were playing their music too loud but you are claiming the comments about their race are false. I got a yes answer every time. About the seventh one, I think the wife caught one. She started complaining that I was dragging it out. I just smiled politely and reminded her that this was my time and she ample opportunity to object and ask me questions, but only after I was done. And then went through the rest and let them build a defense. Then after I was done getting the admit to lies, I informed them that tenants in said apartment were actually out of the country at the time of those 18 reports and that the tenants provided proof that they were gone and my officers checked the apartment one time a night and confirmed that it was empty. Then I smiled pleasantly and ended my part, but the look on their face was a mix of anger and fear. They didn't have a defense. Basically saying myself and the manager were choosing immigrants over Americans. Oh, did I mention the manager as an immigrant? That went over like a hand grenade in a collection plate. Once they said that she stopped it and told them she was, that made matters worse because they said she was just taking up for her own kind. During this, I'm calm and collected. Inside my mind I'm thinking, oh beep. After a few more racial remarks, the manager just stopped them and said guilty and she would process the eviction paperwork with the courts in the morning. Long story short, they were given 14 days. From what I heard, the judge gave them 30 until they called him a racial name. I was able to call the nice Asian couple and let them know that it was over and they didn't have to worry because we would no longer respond to calls about their apartment for the next 14 days until eviction came through and the bad tenants left. But they were welcome to call anytime if they need help or have an issue. Security officers want to help so bad, but are limited by either laws, property management rule or both, so it is nice to do some good. Thank you for watch. Error. Problem detected. Not enough subscribers. Please subscribe, like, and comment.